It's day two, Caprice's turn, and she finds herself in an alien environment, the supermarket.
I'm so nervous. I couldn't sleep last night. I mean, I was knackered after the dinner, but I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, I think I need that. Ooh.
What, all of it? Caprice loves to throw dinner parties, but always avoids doing the dirty work.
I don't really come to shop for raw ingredients for a dinner party. Because normally if I have a dinner party, you know, I'll cater it in or something like that. Yeah. Oop, beep, beep. Excuse me. This is ridiculous. I need help. What's the difference between a cow feta and a barrel-aged feta?
Well, you better make your mind up, because the cheese is for your starter.
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
Spinach and feta phyllo pastry with butternut squash.
Slightly brave of her to be doing a pastry.
She's really cooking this? Cool.
I'm definitely not making the phyllo pastry. When you could buy amazing phyllo pastries, why would you make it? Especially me, are you crazy?
So, hoping to get away with ready-made pastry, Caprice layers the phyllo into a dish. Next, she moves on to the filling. She adds an egg to a bowl of feta, dill, parmesan, cream, and nutmeg, and mixes.
Whatever.
Then, if she can be bothered, she folds in wilted spinach.
Some people say this is enjoyable. It's just mad.
And spoons the mixture into the pastry case, wrapping the layers round it.
Okay, this is definitely not what it's supposed to look like.
So much for model presentation. A final brush of oil and her starter goes in the oven. Time for the next course.
I love chocolate and I love dessert.
Which helps if you're serving chocolate fondant with vanilla ice cream.
Very posh, very posh.
You can't go wrong, can you, with that? That is just amazing.
Well, that remains to be seen.
I'm gonna pour this in here.
Caprice adds melted chocolate to a mixture of eggs and sugar and beats hard.
This is a major workout. An electric blender will definitely be a must of an investment. This is ridiculous. Look at that. Hello.
Oh, hello.
After stirring in flour and buttering her pots, she pours the mixture in.
I have to be really, really careful. I have to watch it, keep an eye on it.
Well, sort of.
Because if I cook it too much, then it won't have the gooey bit in the middle. But then again, you have to cook it just the right amount because it needs to be kind of crunchy and light on the outside.
I thought you didn't know what you were doing. She'll cook it after her first two courses have been served.
Yes! I have the starter done, I have the dessert done, now I just have to prepare the fish.
Caprice's fish for her main is whole baked sea bream with tomatoes, garlic, basil, anchovy sauce, and sourdough bread.
Is that fish? Is that
yes, it's fish.
I just don't like to see the carcass of a dead animal or a fish that you're eating.
Bad luck, Jimmy. She sprinkles chopped anchovy onto a tray of garlic, basil, and tomato. Adds the bream and seasons to bake when her guests arrive.
And voila, that's it.
With three courses down, it's all gone to Caprice's head.
We could call up my mother right now, just randomly, and I could say, Mom, you're not gonna believe what I just cooked tonight for dinner. I cooked a da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And she will say, are you completely on crack?
Your mum would say that. Just time for Caprice to run upstairs and change before her guests arrive. First in is little Jimmy Osmond.
Hello.
Yay, Jimmy!
How are you? Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
What a beautiful place.
No, come in, come in, come in. Come in, come in.
Then hairdresser to the stars, Nicky, with a bottle of champagne that's almost as expensive as one of his haircuts.
Hi, my babe. How are you?
How are you? Ooh. Oh, long time no see.
I know. Come in.
This is
are you serious?
Oh my God.
My babe, you are you crazy?
Are you good?
And lastly, it's Nancy.
How are you doing? Nice to see you. How are you?
Come on, ladies. It's only been 24 hours. Now everyone's arrived, Caprice can put the finishing touches to her starter.
Okay. If it's gross and if I almost vomit, I'm gonna order some pizza in. Okay, ready?
Oh my God, this is so good.
So, the salad's a success, but will anyone notice that shop-bought pastry as Caprice serves her spinach and feta starter?
Is
really good.
It's good.
It's really good.
Really good.
I love the salad, the dressing, everything.
So did you make it all, I mean, including the pastry and stuff like that?
No. I didn't do the pastry. Oh. It's a filo pastry.
That couldn't
be that creative, my babe.
The starter was terrific. I mean, that's my kind of thing. I mean, I love that. You know, that flaky crust, and she said she didn't make that part, but either way, the whole combination, she put it together. I think it counts.
You'd have that in a restaurant. I mean, you know, that's fairly remarkable, really.
So far, so good. It's time for Caprice to pop her main in the oven and then phone her mum in America to give her the surprise news.
Ma? Ma? Okay, are you sitting down? Okay, two things to tell you. One, I'm having a dinner party, which I know is not out of the ordinary. And I'm cooking. Hello? Mom?
With even her mum speechless, Caprice decides to show off her baked fish. Not a good idea for Jimmy.
Guys, will it disturb you if I show you the presentation of the fish?
No, I just hate it when there's too much information.
No, I know.
Kind of like last night.
Oh, I see.
Jimmy,
oh, okay.
Look at his teeth.
I'm going to eat that? Thank you.
It's a mental thing with Jimmy. Jimmy's a great guy. I can't wait to see what he's cooking. He might even leave his own meal. I don't know what's going on.
Not every mealtime in Britain's like this, Jimmy. Time to tuck into the main course, baked sea bream with tomatoes and sourdough bread.
I'm trying to forget about those teeth.
I knew I shouldn't have told you.
No,
I knew it.
It.
I knew it.
This is actually, I'm telling you,
it's really good.
It's more than good.
Mm. Very good.
Thank you, God.
Are you sure you don't have like little leprechauns in there cooking this?
No, I swear to you, it's all on.
Because you said you're not like a cook.
I'm not. I swear
but
to
your
you.
Mom is gonna be so
I think
proud.
We've been sandbagged, everyone. I don't believe she's only cooked twice after that meal, but. I'm not calling her a liar.
I think you are.
Obviously, you know, it doesn't compare to mine. Who can beat Sausage Mountain, eh? Who can beat it?
Well, you'd be surprised.
And some of those cups...
Not content with giving Jimmy too much information about her food, Caprice wants to tell him and everyone else the hidden secrets of making women's underwear.
But there was still that...
I go to the Paris shows twice a year, and then I pick out all my fabrics and my straps and... You know, I do all the legwork.
So there are lingerie shows.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, they're
really?
Huge, massive. They're, it used to be in Lyon and Paris, but now they're both in Paris, and it's twice a year.
Wow.
And
do you want to go?
Massive.
I'd fall apart. I'd fall apart.
Oh, no, it's nothing glamorous.
Okay.
I've done catwalk lingerie shows. I remember going for the casting and getting it and doing it. And
yeah, it's
fun.
Like a...
Can I have some more water?
Yeah, I'll have one as well, please.
We're going to show you.
We're going to do a show just for you.
Oh, my goodness. I think he was thinking we were going to do a little bit of a show for him. I don't think so, Jimmy.
Shame.
I should be able to handle those things, although I put anybody in my situation, I bet they'd go red.
Wow.
Coming up.
Okay, girls.
There's watery weirdness.
What?
Fiery food.
I'm now burning like crazy.
And frosty words.
I don't know.
Sorry.
I think we should go this way, my babe.